What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and this past week was very eventful, but also very strange, as we got multiple software updates scattered throughout the week. So on Monday, Apple released iOS and iPadOS 15.2, along with macOS Monterey 12.1, watchOS 8.3, and all of the other software Apple usually rolls out. And then on Thursday, Apple released macOS Monterey 12.2 Beta 1, and that was it. Nothing else came on that Thursday. And then came Friday, late Friday afternoon, when Apple dropped iOS and iPadOS 15.3 Beta 1, along with watchOS 8.4 and tvOS 15.3 Beta 1. But that wasn't the original plan, and we'll explain what I mean by that in a moment. But in this video, we're going to be discussing some additional new features and changes in iOS 15.2 and 15.3, along with an update on the performance, battery life, bugs, and more. So before we get into how the latest iOS versions have been running for the past week, we need to talk about something that rarely ever happens with Apple software, and that is a leak. So remember how I said that a new beta of macOS Monterey was released on Thursday, but nothing else? Well, that was not the original plan. So according to Apple's own website and the leaked build of iOS 15.3 Beta 1, this software, along with watchOS 8.4 and tvOS 15.3, were also set to be released on Thursday the 16th alongside macOS Monterey 12.2 Beta 1. Now, we don't know exactly why Apple delayed the release by a day, but that's besides the point. I mean, the fact that people were able to get into Apple's developer portal and download the IPSW file of an unreleased iOS build is wild. And I don't think it's ever happened before, at least not that I remember, maybe one time ever if it has. And what's even more strange is that Apple didn't even remove, you know, the code or the traces of code on their own website. Instead, they just commented out the rows in HTML, like in the HTML code, they commented it out so that people on the front end of the website couldn't see it. But a very simple right click and show page source would show you a very clear 15.3, watchOS 8.4, and tvOS 15.3 along with that release date there. So super strange stuff, and I did actually end up installing iOS 15.3, the leaked version, on my iPhone 11, but I didn't install it on, you know, one of my main devices like the 13 Pro Max until it officially released later on in the day. So super strange, but we'll talk about 15.3 a little bit more in this video. But let's first talk about the version that most of you are on right now, and that's 15.2. All right, so the first thing I want to talk about is a new feature in 15.2 that I did not cover here on the channel, and that is that you can now erase a disabled device without needing to restore from a computer. So if you get your, you know, password wrong multiple times and you can't sign in, you can see right here that you now have erase phone on the lock screen, and you don't have to actually plug it into your computer to restore. You could erase all the data straight from the lock screen right here. So you can see here on Apple's website, it outlines what would happen once you tap on erase iPhone. So you'll have to enter in your Apple ID and password, and then you'll tap erase again, and it will permanently delete all of your data and settings. So that's all going to happen on device now. You don't need to plug it into a computer to do that. And you can see right here, you do need to be on iOS 15.2 or later to be able to do this. And of course, you will need to be connected to cellular or Wi-Fi as well. I also wanted to point out that the new parts and service history feature, which shows in your settings general about, and it will show if you have genuine Apple parts or not. If you got, you know, a part replaced, like your battery, your camera, or your display, it will show either genuine Apple part or not. A lot of people are reporting that's working great in 15.2, but some people are seeing it get improved even more and show more data in 15.3, which we'll talk about here in a moment. But this feature was introduced with 15.2, and I don't have a device that I've replaced anything on, so I cannot, you know, see this myself. But from everybody I've been seeing on social media, things seem to be going good with this feature, and it's going to help a lot of people in the secondhand market when they go to buy an iPhone. Great feature. I really love this, and this is definitely one of the most underrated features in 15.2. I also wanted to point out that there are a ton of security patches in iOS and iPadOS 15.2. I mean, just look at this list, and I will leave this in the description down below as well. But if you needed more reason to update to 15.2, I mean, just tons of bug fixes, tons of vulnerabilities have been patched in this update. So if you want to make sure your device is as secure as possible, make sure you go ahead and update to 15.2. I mean, this is just another reason on top of all the new features and changes, bug fixes and things like that, that you should strongly consider updating. Now, we did also see the release of Swift Playgrounds 4. So if you have an iPad and you're on iPadOS 15.2, you will be able to download Swift Playgrounds 4.0. So this is going to allow you to essentially create applications, iPhone and iPad applications, straight from your iPad without the need of a computer whatsoever. It's basically like a mini Xcode. I played around with this for a little bit and it's actually really awesome. You're not going to be making, you know, top-selling games just straight from the iPad. You're going to want to use a computer for that. But if you just want to, you know, do this in your spare time or just create a little fun game or just a fun little app, it's awesome that you can now do that for free using Swift Playgrounds 4 straight from iPadOS. Again, that's awesome. But as far as anything else goes, you know, I've covered pretty much everything here in 15.2. I've been covering this software for over a month now, so I've covered just about every feature possible in this update. But of course, we don't have any new emoji. We don't have wallpapers. We don't have the digital driver's license. Hopefully we'll get all of those in early 2022 before iOS 16. I would expect new emojis and potentially new wallpapers maybe in like 15.4. So maybe around springtime is when we could see that. I'm not too sure, but it's not looking like we're going to see that in 15.3. And of course, we did not get anything new related to those in 15.2. Now, as far as bugs go in iOS 15.2, I did have a really weird bug the other day on my daily device, my iPhone 13 Pro here. And you can see here, the day I installed, or maybe it's the day after, on Tuesday, the day after I installed 15.2, I got this really weird status bar bug. So you can see here, the time and everything is on the right side of my screen. Now, what's weird about this is that I always keep rotation lock on, always, 24/7. I never take it off. So the fact that my status bar went all the way over to the right like that is really, really strange. I even took a video recording here, a screen recording of it, because it just simply would not move. So it would go up to the top when I went into an application, but when I went back to the home screen, it would go off to the side, which was just very strange. You can see here on Twitter as well, just a really weird bug that I had in iOS 15.2. But aside from that, I'm really not having any other issues with 15.2. The spotlight bug has been fixed for me. So when I would go into Spotlight Search, sometimes it would show no applications, even though I had those applications installed. That has finally been fixed. And then also the music streaming bug is pretty much a non-issue at this point. I have not noticed any battery drain whatsoever on any of my devices on 15.2. And then as far as performance goes here on 15.2, I've had a lot less bugs on this version since installing it, which is, you know, kind of ironic since I've just mentioned that status bar bug, but that's really the extent of the bugs I've had on 15.2. I mean, performance has been excellent so far. If that's the worst bug I'm having, that's a win in my book. So everything's looking good on 15.2 as far as performance goes. And same with battery life. I mean, battery life is pretty great. It is a minor increase over 15.1.1, but you know, nothing too crazy. It's not a huge jump. It's just about the same, just a little bit better, I would say. Maybe like 20 minutes more of on-screen time I've noticed. And if we go into my settings here and go to the battery section, you guys can see my battery graphs right here. Of course, I charge my phone throughout the day just with my Tesla charger when I set it on the charger in my car. So that's why you see little spurts of charging throughout the day and night. But you guys can see there, pretty solid battery life overall. Here's where my battery life is going in terms of which applications I'm using on a daily basis. But you can see there, I've been using my phone quite a bit lately. Of course, over the past 10 days, you can see here, using it quite a bit. Of course, trying to test out iOS 15.2 and just how good or bad the battery life is. And so far, it's been a lot more on the good side than it has been on the bad side. All right, so now let's go ahead and move on to the community poll. And there we go, on the home screen, you can see the poll pops up right here. But if you go to my channel and then go to community, is this new right here? This must be new in the YouTube application. I like that there. But if you go to my channel and go to community, you guys will see this is the poll that I just recently posted. And I said, iOS 15.2 has been out for a few days. How is it running for you? So for me, I'm having no issues with 15.2. And you can see there, that is the most popular answer. So 60% of 16,000 people that voted said that 15.2 is great with no issues. 14% said good, just minor issues. 7% said not good, buggy and bad battery life. And then 20% are still not on 15.2, whether that be 15.1 or iOS 14. So let's go ahead and read through a couple of these comments. Someone here has an issue when tapping on the camera app. Sometimes it crashes. So I'm not sure if you're talking about the camera app on the home screen or from the lock screen, but that's interesting. So I've not heard of that where it just crashes right away. However, battery life and performance is awesome and one of the best in a long time. That's good to hear. So Hedge here says, some minor issues on my 12 Pro Max, like keyboard randomly not showing up in search. If you're talking about the spotlight search, yes, that's happened to me before too. But the biggest issue I've had with 15.2 is the accessibility shortcut taking up to several seconds to activate. I use it for reduced white point. So interesting. So there are a lot of variables with accessibility. So hopefully that is something that will be solved pretty soon. A lot of people are saying that 15.2 is better in terms of performance. Battery life seems better than the betas, and 15.1 is I have no major issues or bugs. Good to hear. 15.2 has been very stable so far on my 12 Pro Max. I've gotten better battery life on one day. I nearly reached 10 hours of screen on time on a single charge. That's impressive. That's awesome. I'm getting improved Wi-Fi connectivity, maybe due to a modem update, and schedule summary is more refined. It's less cumbersome compared to previous versions. Yeah, the new, you know, scheduled summary looks so much better in this update, in my opinion. Let me see if I have it here. So yeah, I mean, it just looks so much better. It looks so much more modern than really anything we've seen on the lock screen, maybe ever on iOS. I mean, it just looks so full and so cool. I really love it. Especially when you tap on it too, you get this really awesome view there. That's definitely one of my favorite things in 15.2. But anyway, good to see it's running well for you. Only thing I've noticed is battery life since iOS 15.1. It's gotten noticeably worse on my 12 Pro Max. So yeah, people are going to say that battery life is worse. People are going to say that it's better. It just all depends really on how you use your phone. So unfortunately, you know, can't really do much if you're having much worse battery life and you follow all of my battery saving tips, unfortunately. Here we go. Here's an iPhone XR user. I've been waiting on somebody with a XR to comment because a lot of people on 15.1 had issues that were on the XR. So Nana says the 15.2 has been great on my iPhone XR. My cellular bars have improved and my Wi-Fi speed is way better. But for battery, it's been getting really good battery per day, around 5 hours, which I would say is good for me since I don't use it that much. So good to hear there. 13 thumbs up. A lot of comments here as well. So yeah, a lot of people seem to agree with that on the iPhone XR. So that is good news for those of you because I know a lot of people, again, on the XR had pretty bad things to say about 15.1 and 15.1.1. Notification summary bug has been resolved, 10 out of 10. Great to hear. Here's a potential new feature in 15.2 that I did not cover here on the channel from Chris. He says that with 15.2, you can now give access to Apple Family Sharing for users with different regions than you. So that's good to hear that that's now a feature available with 15.2. I did not know about that. Wi-Fi calling is broken for the third time with this update. They fixed it with 15.1, but now it's broken again. So if you guys have Wi-Fi calling, let me know if that's broken for you as well down in the comments below here on 15.2. But I don't use Wi-Fi calling, so I can't test that. I guess I could test it, but I don't use that personally. Hopefully 15.3 or maybe even a 15.2.1 will fix that though. But thanks to everybody who did leave a comment on this poll, this community post. I did go ahead and read all of them. So thank you to everybody who left a comment. And of course, everybody who voted as well. It really helps us out here on the channel to see how these software versions are running. And if you guys missed this video, by the way, make sure you watch that. An awesome video. I really enjoyed making that. Now, I did also want to mention macOS Monterey 12.1 and 12.2 Beta 1 in this video as well, because I'm currently using both. So 12.1 has been terrific for me on my M1 Max MacBook Pro. I made a video on all of the new features and changes, and those were nice, but the bug fixes are the main reason I'm glad that I updated right away. So a couple of the things I noticed is that the memory leak bug has been fixed. Like, none of my memory is leaking at all on this latest version. Also, Final Cut Pro does not randomly crash anymore. So I had a weird issue, really strange issue, where Final Cut Pro would just randomly crash, or sometimes it just wouldn't close. Like, I would click on the X and it just would not close. I would have to force quit it. So both of those have been resolved with macOS Monterey 12.1. Also, the trackpad bug has been fixed, so I can actually use my trackpad again now. I could not use it at all on macOS Monterey 12 or 12.0.1, so that has been fixed. And just overall, it's a much needed update that I'm very, very pleased with. Now, as far as macOS Monterey 12.2 Beta 1, This has improved scrolling in Safari with ProMotion on the MacBook Pro. Now, of course, my MacBook Pro, my main M1 Max MacBook Pro that has ProMotion, is my main device. So I'm not putting the beta on that, so I cannot test this, but a lot of people are seeing improved, 120 hertz scrolling in Safari on that ProMotion display with this new macOS Monterey 12.2. So that's good, especially because a lot of people are complaining about stutter on Safari in 12.1. And then also on 12.2 beta 1, Apple is completely rebuilding Apple Music and making it a full native application. So now everything's going to be a lot faster, like searching for songs and things like that will be much faster and more fluid after updating to macOS Monterey 12.2. So can't wait to see what else comes with that update, but that's about it so far on that. I only have it installed on my Mac Mini, not on my MacBook Pro, my M1 Max MacBook Pro. But overall, loving these macOS Monterey updates. And then going back to the iPhone, iOS 15.3 Beta 1 has been great so far. Now, one thing I did mention in the video, the What's New video, is that there was some verbiage changes in the podcast application, but I didn't really get too specific. So basically, it was in this section right here when you would go to library and you had, hide completed episodes or whatever the option is, it would say this right here. It would say all caught up, all your latest episodes are played and hidden by a filter. So just the verbiage right there is changed with 15.3. Very, very minor, but that was one of the things I mentioned that I needed to kind of expand on. And then I did also want to mention that there are no signs of CSAM in 15.3 beta 1. So the code has been scoured and there are no signs of CSAM at all. There are just fixes in the communication safety feature, of course, that I talked about in that video and earlier in this video as well, but there is no mention of CSAM anywhere. So don't expect that to be added with 15.3. And then also the parts and service history feature now shows properly for certain devices. So it shows more information now on 15.3 beta 1. So you can see here this Reddit user has an iPhone SE, and now in 15.3 it shows his display and not just his battery, if it's been replaced using a genuine Apple part or not. So it looks like more information added for select devices. And then as far as battery life and performance overall, both are solid so far, and I haven't really noticed a single bug yet on 15.3 beta 1. It's only been one day, but still, it's a good sign for what's to come with this software. All right, so now what's next from Apple? So today is Saturday, December 18th, and unfortunately, I don't think we're going to be seeing a new software update for at least a couple of weeks. So I think we're going to be seeing iOS 15.3 beta 2. I think that's the next iOS release that we will see. And I think that's coming either on the week of January 3rd or more likely the week of January 10th. So we'll have to wait and see, but I think the earliest it will come is on the week of January 3rd. So again, could come anytime within those first 2 weeks of January. I don't see it coming any later than the week of the 10th. So that's the next release that we can expect along with all the other software as expected. Now, as far as a public release, we could be seeing a 15.2.1 at some point in January, maybe mid to late January, because we will see some bug fixes in that update. And of course, we won't have 15.3 final until sometime in February. That's my guess. But anyways, guys, there you have it. That is the latest on iOS 15.2, 15.3, and a little bit of macOS Monterey goodness in this video as well. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up, and of course make sure to subscribe if you want to stay up to date on all of these new software releases from Apple. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.